think I'm spontaneous. I don't get into all the drama that other girls seem to crave. I like to paint. I even like to read. There, I said it. Secret is out. I enjoy reading. My nickname at home when I was little was Squirmy Wormy because I could never sit still. I always wanted to go outside and play with my sister. I even squirmed in my sleep, kicking the sheets off of my bed. My parents enjoyed my energy and were always so impressed on how I was able to keep up on family vacations where we would hike and ride bikes and my older sister would lag behind. They called her Lazy Daisy. And then I started elementary school and I loved it. I had the best teacher ever in first grade. Every 30 minutes, she would change up the activity so I would never get bored. And if I did get bored, I knew that I could read or I could draw until the class was ready to move on to something else. Life was great. Until we had to take the state-mandated standardized test. It was something like 4 hours long, and I could do all the reading. I understood all the questions, but why did they have to ask so many of them? Couldn't they have just checked the first 10 and see that I was smart? Six. I didn't know that one test would freak so many people out, so I bubbled in whatever I wanted to, because I knew that once I was done, I could do something else. Something new. Something creative. I didn't think I was broken. But when I got to second grade, they started pulling me out for other tests. Special tests. My second grade teacher didn't change things up like my first grade teacher did. In second grade, she expected us to spend an hour and a half entirely on social studies, and it was all book work. We just read and wrote and got ready for the big state test. And it was so boring. And that's when I discovered a loophole.
No, you may not go to the bathroom. Now, quit disrupting your peers.
After all the special tests were done, they diagnosed me with ADHD, attention deficit hyperactive disorder. I didn't know what it meant at the time, but I did know my second grade teacher had an acute case of boringitis. I was 7. It was very confusing to me. In first grade, my teacher loved me and called me smart. But in second grade, I had become a problem child because I got bored. My parents were reluctant, but the school said that the tests were very accurate and that the only solution was to have me start taking medication. Before that day, I only took medication when I felt sick. I didn't feel sick. I felt like me. I felt like everybody else. But all the adults were saying I was different. They started me on Concerta. It's sort of like Ritalin. Side effects may include
dizziness, drowsiness, dry mouth, headache,
increased sweating,
and weight loss.
Severe reactions may lead to
swelling of the mouth, face, lips, or tongue,
aggression, blurred vision,
confusion,
persistent crying, suicidal thoughts,
uncontrolled speech or muscle movement,
and the possibility of
hallucinations.
Some kids out there who really do need medication to function. I wish I would have been born 30 years ago, back when my parents were kids. Back then, they would have called it a phase. Maybe just realized that I simply didn't mesh with my second.